money. I love it, I hate it, I want it, I need it. And please, sir, as I hold out my porridge bowl, more. That about sums it up. Most of us old enough to be living in a retirement community grew up during the Great Depression. Money, 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 the lack of it, the hard times, the parental scrimping, the family quarrels over it. All that must have put its thumbprint on us as children of that era. It stands to reason that it has skewed our attitude towards money in a ways that are different from our children and grandchildren. What that thumbprint is differs from person to person. We all know the skinflints, the cautious, the profligates. It's not a one attitude fits all, but the fact is a postage stamp costs more nowadays than the movies did when we were kids. What a laugh. Well, maybe our grandchildren will feel the pinch as we did when we were kids. They may have to learn to scrimp and save. Who knows in these chaotic times? But I bet the subject of money will always be interesting, complicated, and hard to talk about. I know that I never had any idea how much my father earned or didn't earn. It was a taboo subject. It is still. How much one has or doesn't have is still the same off limits. A taboo subject. What is more interesting is how the idea of what constitutes riches changes with aging. There was a time in our lives when envy was directed at someone with a fancy car or a big house, and so forth, things that money could buy, if only we had more of it. But now, for us, there's a different number one on the hit parade. The truly rich, the ones to envy now, are those who can walk, who can see and hear, and who can drive at night, for heaven's sakes. They have what we want most, and money doesn't get it for us. However, having enough is critical now that we're old. We have enough troubles without having to deal with privation. As the cliché goes, money can't buy happiness, and we know it can't buy health. But then if you ask what good it is, chances are you're loaded.